Welcome back to Living Black. Born out of the fight for equal rights in the 1970s, the Black Theatre Company fused political activism with performing arts. The result was a cultural revolution. Alan Clark looks back at the legacy of black theatre and those who found an artistic refuge within it.
It was a time of change, a unified Aboriginal voice demanding equal rights, culminating in waves of protests. But violent clashes with police could not stop the rising tide of political upheaval in 1970s Australia. Amidst this human rights movement was a beating artistic heart. Out of the darkness, a glimpse into Sydney's Redfern in the early 70s. Now a suburb mired in controversy, was once a hotbed of Aboriginal political activism and performance. Much of it centred around the now defunct National Black Theatre Company.
There was a renaissance that occurred in this country, and it was revisiting Aboriginal arts and culture. But specifically, there was a real grasp of the political movement. Would this show have got up if they weren't commissioned by having...
Earlier this year, a comprehensive retrospect shone a spotlight on this period of innovative forward thinkers.
Look, it was an incredible time, and it was a difficult time. It was still a time when Australia had the White Australia policy. So you're looking at a group of the new generation of young men and women who were ready to be vocal about the inequalities in this country.
Is it a bat? Is it a crow? Is it the flying doctor? No, it's Superbong.
The Black Theatre Company often produced provocative works. Infamous black superhero Superbong and the play Here Comes the Nigger to publicise human rights abuses.
And this is where it all began. In this house in the 70s, a group of political activists and artists got together. It would spawn a generation of new Indigenous theatre and introduce political activism into the world of arts.
Now an empty terrace, it was once home to some of the nation's most prolific Aboriginal personalities. Some of them include actor and Order of Australia Medal recipient Justine Saunders, actor Bob Mazza, and Australia's first published Aboriginal playwright Kevin Gilbert. The troupe even led a theatrical protest in Canberra outside Parliament House, ending in dozens of arrests.
I think it's a great reflection that we look at what those people gave, particularly when you think many of these men and women were incarcerated. They'd written their work in terrible conditions, but they really wanted to write about the state of the Aboriginal man and woman living in Australia during that period.
Today, many are deceased, but their legacy and spirit lives on stages across the country.
And remember, if you'd like to comment on that story, just go to our Facebook page.